The last thing that anybody wants is to send our students back to school and then have to pull them back.
The first day of school is right around the corner. This year, students in Chesterfield will start classes virtually. The school board made the decision in July, and they created a public health committee to determine when kids should return to in-person learning.
The testing turnaround time is going to be a factor in terms of how we look at this moving forward.
Tuesday, that special committee shared updates with the board. Right now, they are looking to bring students back in phases by cohorts, starting with special education students. Cohort 2 would include pre-K through second grade. Each grade would be assigned a cohort, and students would return to the classroom gradually. But this plan would only be implemented if data shows the spread of COVID-19 is declining within the county.
Our goal is to have 50% or less of our student population in the schoolhouse at any one time so that we can maintain social distancing.
To keep the distance, the plan would limit the amount of days each cohort was in the building. For example, cohort 1 would have in-person learning 4 days a week, while cohorts 2 through 4 would only meet 2 days a week. The committee says PPE supplies would be provided.
This is everything from gowns to masks to hand sanitizer stations to personal hand sanitizer bottles to gloves.
Right now, the committee is recommending September 29th as the earliest possible return to class date, but that's if COVID-19 numbers go down. They say their most important objective is to keep kids safe.
We would like to do this once, get it right, send them to school, start adding cohorts every other week, and make sure that our kids are safe, and do this the right way versus having to pause or start pulling kids back.
Now again, students in Chesterfield will start school virtually on September 8th. Meanwhile, school board leaders will meet again on September 14th to hear another update from the Public Health Committee. Working for you, I'm Matthew Foltz, CBS 6 News.